Code red! Code red, guys! Guys, we got a code red on our hands.
What?
Oh my gosh, hang on. Now, according to my sources in the field, the waitress is seeing somebody.
Do you know who this guy is?
No, I have no idea, man. I just got like a shady readout on the guy. Look, I tell you what, Maxine, how is you my best friend? Maybe you can look into it for me, you know? Go down there, snoop around the shop.
Can I stop it for a second? I'm sorry, I'm a little confused here. You just said that he was your best friend. How is he your best friend over me?
Well, I mean, you banged the waitress. Do I even have to explain that to you? That kind of rubbed me the wrong way, dude.
Okay, I mean, I don't see how that should factor into whether we're best friends or not. You know, to be honest with you, man, I'm a little shocked. I'm thunderstruck.
Well, I'm sorry, man, but, you know, I didn't mean to hurt you. I didn't mean to thunderstrike you, but that's just, I don't know what to tell you. What
I
do you want to hear?
For you to explain to me how it is that you consider Mac to be a better friend to you.
This is just becoming awkward when I have a real problem, and all of a sudden it's about some weird feelings thing. And it's not about your feelings right now, it's about my feelings because I have a problem, okay? Now, Mac, please, do you think you can find this guy and kick his ass for me?
Absolutely, bro. I will find this guy and I will kick his ass. You know why? Because you and I are best friends. He's on to us.
Gas generator.
About a week ago. I've been doing it for about a week.
Why would you do that?
Well, because, you know, electricity's so expensive, man. So I figured let's get a generator and, you know, run the bar on it.
Are you kidding me? Gasoline's like 1,000 times more expensive than electricity.
And you know what, Charlie? You shouldn't be making these decisions anyway, okay? You're not the decision-making type.
Mom gave all of our money to Bruce. You were never gonna get it anyway.
Oh, no, I was. See, I had a plan. I was gonna eliminate everybody else and be the only surviving heir, so help.
So when you say eliminate, you mean you were gonna kill me?
I don't know. No, yes, maybe I was going to, maybe I was. The point is moot now, so can you please help me out here?
So you were planning on killing me.
Oh, listen,
stop arguing. Are you gonna help us or not? We got no time here.
Pass.
Pass?
Yeah, pass. Super pass. Uber pass.
How do you super pass on something like this?
We gotta get that money back. I pass! Because you were planning on killing me.
Oh my god, I feel like you're really focused on one tiny part of what I'm trying to talk about here.
It's a very big part of your...
It's just a couple of words.
Just go away. I'm trying to draw breasts
and
pretty women.
And Bruce and me.
You give us a shitload of money. We buy a shitload of gasoline. We wait 12 months, we sell the gasoline, and make a shitload of profit.
Gentlemen, we tend to give loans to businesses, not...
She's not getting it. Get the graph.
Oh, yeah, the graph.
We have a graph.
Yeah.
Check this out. Now, these are the gas prices last year. These are the gas prices this year. And this is what the gas prices will be.
And what are those?
These are gorgeous women with heaving breasts.
Yeah. Why?
Well, to be perfectly honest, we sort of thought we'd be speaking to a man today, so...
Yeah. Is there any way that we could talk to your boss? Because I think he would understand more better.
My boss is a woman.
Really?
Your boss is a woman? Now, this is a strange bank.
Okay, well, I am definitely rejecting your request for $300,000 to buy gasoline.
My intel tells me that Bruce moved into this crappy apartment complex.
Where'd you get your intel?
I waterboarded some guy, told me everything.
You tortured somebody?
Oh, yeah, big time. What do you see?
I can't see shit. Why would you tint the inside of the windows?
I don't want anybody to see in.
We can't see out, Frank.
I might have overdone it a little
You think
bit.
So?
Whoa, that's Bruce.
This guy?
That's the guy. Walk in there. Start the car.
Are you sure?
Let's follow him. I'm going to take some pictures. I got him working.
All right,
go.
The gas pedal's stuck.
Well, wobble it.
Wobble it?
Yeah, wobble it back and forth. Wheel it.
All right.
That's it. Now get it.
Oh, God.
What are you doing?
Well, you're blinding me. Will you calm down for a second? Hold on.
All right, who the hell is this character that you're doing?
Oh, this one? It's a really great one. Her name's Martina Martinez, and she is a streetwise Puerto Rican girl who's always quick with a sassy comeback.
Are you serious?
Yes, it's awesome. Now, let's go over what we're doing again. I go up, I talk, you come in with the volleyball, you hit him in the face, and you get out of there.
Okay, I'm gonna hit a random person in the face with the volleyball.
Okay, but don't come in too early, because I got some material I want to do, I don't want you to cut me off. Saturday Night Live is gonna really, I think they're gonna really
do
love
it. Really
Charlie, point it that way.
Yeah. Go.
You know, I'm horrified that he's here.
Excuse me, can I talk to you?
What?
You're supposed to white boys, right? Can I ask you a question? When you be in the clubs and you be dancing, why you look so stupid? I'm just playing. So, big man, right? But you got such tiny boots on. That means you got a small pecker. I'm sorry. I'm just playing. I'm Martina Montana.
Dee, what the hell's going on here?
I don't know. Doesn't she look ridiculous?
Get out of here.
Porn star or something.
He almost didn't recognize
you. You guys shooting a
porn? No, we're not.
Never mind. I don't care. Listen, we need to get that company credit card from Frank.
Yeah, what's up?
Man, dude, I realized something. I don't need validation anymore. How great is that? But what I do need is I need the company credit card so that I can buy myself a billboard, get myself out there, and show the entire world that Dennis Reynolds still has a rockin' body that deserves to be worshipped.
Get out of here. We're in the middle of something.
No, you get out of here.
But this is
help me get the credit card.
Get out.
I need that billboard.
Hang on a second. Okay, look, guys. There's a way to make you guys both happy, all right? I got a pretty good plan how to do this.
Hey, everybody. Pathetic Girl 43 here, coming to you live with Philadelphia's next top model, Dennis Reynolds. Dennis, tell us what it's like to be so handsome.
Well, I like to think I've been this handsome since birth, possibly even earlier.
That is correct.
And Mr. Kelly, in your sworn statement to police, you've claimed that the prisoner told you that if you didn't, and I quote, jam a bunch of stuff into your butt, he was going to rape you so hard the room would stink. Then he was going to, quote, eat your butt and his son's butt in the stink until his stomach was full of your butts. Is this correct?
That is also correct. Oh, man, I'm sorry.
Warden, they're lying. I do not want to hurt them. In fact, I want to get as far away from those two as I possibly can.
Objection! That's an objection, Your Honor.
Hey!
Move to strike!
Quiet! Sit down! Sit down! Sit down! Get your hands off the microphone!
Wow.
Just leave it in the middle of the two of you. Leave it alone.
Put it in the
middle. Take your hands off the mic. Leave it alone. Leave it there.
Yes. A few weeks ago, they came to apologize for getting me arrested. I did not accept their apology.
That never happened. Quiet.
Quiet at the hearing.
Oh, yeah, Dad? Not going to accept our apology? Okay, fine. Plan B, bitch. We're going to bury you. Yeah, Mr. Mack. I'm going to tell those parole board dickheads that you said you're going to rape my butt until the room stinks. And then you're going to eat my butt until your stomach is full of butt. Full of my butt and full of Mac's butt.
You're not going to say it exactly like
I'm going to say something like that. Yeah, I think all the butt business is really going to sell it.
That's it. I got it. Forget the bindle. The only way that my dad is not going to kill us is if he thinks we're already dead.
Oh, great. I was hoping you'd say that. Great. Let's kill ourselves. Let's do it.
No, you didn't let me finish.
It's no problem, dude. I'm totally on board. Okay, I'm going to grab a knife. I'm going to jab it into your neck. I'll yank it out. Okay, then your blood's going to start going
everywhere.
No, buddy,
listen.
You'll die in 5 or 10 minutes. And then depending on how horrific that looks, I'll probably do it myself, too.
Okay, listen. I was going to say we fake our own death.
Yeah?
And then he thinks we're dead, and he leaves us alone.
Yeah, right. Either way works, dude. Let's just pick one before he gets here.
Let's pick the second one.
All right,
let's pick the second one.
Where we
don't actually
calm
die.
Down. We'll pick the second one.
Are you sure we have to do this?
Charlie, yes, we have to do this. Look, if the cops are gonna identify the bodies, we need to leave dental records behind, right? So we leave a couple of teeth, bing, bang, boom.
I know, I feel like it's gonna hurt.
Yeah, it's gonna hurt like a bitch. Okay, ready?
Mm-hmm.
One, two,
uh-oh.
Wait, that just kinda came out on its own.
Yeah, that slipped right out, huh?
I barely pulled that.
Whoa.
I barely pulled it. What?
Damn, dude.
That's another.
Man, you should really brush your teeth more because that is not normal.
Oh,
Charlie, stop pulling your teeth out
they're
like that,
just
man.
Right
it's freaking
out.
Me out.
And then they, like, slip right
it's
out.
It's really freaking me out.
Oh, shit.
You think it's my dad?
Of course it's your dad, dude.
Charlie, open up.
I'm thinking maybe 3 feet from the wall.
Okay.
We jump out to safety. The car explodes in a hot ball of fury, and we're dead to the world.
Okie dokie. Good luck with that.
Wait, where are you going, dude?
Well, I'm gonna watch you do it.
No, we need to do it together.
I know, but
that's
I'm
not
really doing anything.
No, yes, you are, Charlie. You're here for moral support.
I know,
support.
But if no one's actually seeing us jump out of the car,
well,
whatever,
it's we're going to kill ourselves
I'm
together.
Watch you.
No,
look,
okay,
man, you
up,
can
get
do
up,
it.
Get up, get up. I'll do it myself.
The whole thing's going to be better without me anyway, Mac. I'm telling you, it's going to be great without me. All right, buddy, good luck.
Pussy.
Ah! Ah! Ah!
Excuse me, sir. Hi, we are in desperate need of something that will destroy a car and annihilate any traces of a human being.
Let me see what I got.
All right, you see that?
Yeah.
Your old buddy here knows what he's doing every now and then,
yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
That's right, I'm the boss, but I'm a good boss, and I'm gonna allow you to watch. Okay, Fricka! Oh, somebody's coming. Any minute now, the German broad is gonna knock on that wall, which is my signal to go in my pants, take out my penis, and stick it through the hole. Then she can go to town.
Hey, honey, you want to take care of this monster for me or what?
There is no way I can picture that as a girl.
Frank?
Dennis!
What the hell are you doing here, man?
Jan sent me.
Jan sent me, too.
This is bad.
Okay, just the littlest bit snug, aren't they? There we go. Cute though, huh? How much?
700.
700? Yes, well, I tell you what, you pay for quality. Because there's so much crap out there these days. Man, I am excited to bust my dogs out in these tonight. We're going to a French restaurant, Le Bistro. It's 5-star, so I don't know if you've been to it coming up. That
sounds great, but this has been declined.
Declined? You're kidding me. Ugh. It makes me so mad, you know, like the credit card companies, the way they waste your time. Probably protecting me. I spent a lot of money today. Try that one.
Excuse me.
Guys, check it out. We got a review in the paper.
No read it, way. read it.
Good review? The first thing I noticed about Patty's Pub is its charm.
All right, it's a good review.
Okay.
All right,
it's a good start.
It has none.
Uh-oh.
Are you serious? There was an ominous feeling that you could get stabbed at any moment.
That's good, right?
How is that good?
That's the exact type of atmosphere I've been trying to cultivate. But while danger may linger, I'm the level-headed bouncer that keeps violence in check, like Swayze in Roadhouse. I'm the cooler.
In check? There have been many stabbings in here.
Yeah, I feel unsafe here every single day.
Oh, very often.
Well, stabbings have been down, though.
They have been down.
Read some more. Hi, are you Mr. Lyle Corman?
Yes, can I help you?
Hi, nice to meet you.
Yeah.
We're here from Patty's Pub,
yes.
And we have come down to give you the opportunity to give us another chance.
Yeah, here's the thing. We felt that your first review was just a tiny bit off base.
Yeah, as you can see, we're not white trash.
Yeah.
So.
Huh, really? Well, then in that case, can you ask your friend to put down that hammer, please?
Don't let the hammer throw you, Corman. We are classy, interesting people.
Oh, okay, I'm afraid I'm gonna have to ask you to leave.
Well, don't be rude. We just came to have a talk, so.
This is a private office. I'm gonna have to get security.
Okay, we can play it that way, Corman. But you should know that we would have no problem suing you.
Suing me? What are you going to sue me for?
Libel, slander. There's two of the big dogs right there.
It's only libel if what I write is false.
You know what, buddy? We will jam your asshole up with so many lawyers, you won't know what to do with yourself.
I'll have you know we have a team of lawyers on retainer just to deal with people like you.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, check this out.
Oh. You're all out of time, bitch!
Boom!
You just got phased.
This just in, poo-poo pants. People don't read newspapers anymore.
Oh, how's that for class?
What the shit is this?
Cheech over here bought himself a bong.
Oh, DeAndre, this is wacky. Hey, go download me a hoagie off the internet.
I'm sorry? Those words don't make any sense. Oh, God, you guys. Oh, weird. I feel weird.
Rip another one,
yeah, say something else stupid, too.
My arm's kind of numb. Dennis, can you feel my head? Is it hot? Am I hot?
I'm not touching you.
We're enjoying ourselves over
here.
Yeah. I'm serious, you guys. Something's not right.
I think there's pigeons in the bar.
I feel like...
Pigeons in the bar.
I mean, really serious, you guys. I need some help.
Good one.
Yeah. God, what is her problem?
Jesus Christ, dude.
What's going on in here?
Oh, I'm really behind the eight ball, Mac. The mail doesn't stop, bud.
You smoking now?
Yeah, I'm smoking now. Are you kidding me? My nerves are like... Blah, 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 blah. So I'm trying to smoke. I'm trying to calm myself down. And hey, we got insurance, so what the hell? Have a smoke.
Yeah, maybe you're right, because I need to calm my nerves a bit, dude. It's a shark tank up there.
Oh, yeah? Is it? I bet. Have some coffee, too. That'll calm you down.
Yeah. What's your system here, bro?
Oh, it's pretty complicated. The mail goes into three sections according to how important I think the thing looks, okay? Now, the least important stuff, I'm gonna burn that. If it's important, they're gonna send it again, right? The middle important stuff, I put that back in the mail addressed to me, so I buy myself a couple more days. And the most important stuff, that gets delivered. You know something, Mac? I actually burn that too most of the time.
Okay, well, it looks like you've got this under control. I'm gonna get back to my office.
Sorry, bud. Sorry, bud.
Yeah, no, I'm just looking.
The mail won't stop.
Okay, sorry, buddy. All right, I'm gonna get back to my office, and then, you know, I'll see you later.
Yeah, all right, man.
Okay, bud. Okay,
stop. You're not gonna stop, are you?
Good. That's good. Hello, Chief.
They're on to me, dude. Those guys are sharp as nails up there. You can't put anything past them. Oh, my God, dude. I'm freaking out. I am so stressed out. I feel like I'm having a panic attack.
You want to talk about stress? You want to talk about stress? Okay? I've stumbled onto a major company conspiracy, Mac. How about that for stress?
What the hell are you talking about?
This company is being bled like a stuck pig, Mac, and I got a paper trail to prove it. Check this out. Take a look at this.
Jesus Christ, Charlie.
That right there is the mail. Now, let's talk about the mail. Can we talk about the mail, please, Mac? I'm dying to talk about the mail for you all day, okay? Pepe Silvia, this name keeps coming up over and over again. Every day, Pepe's mail's getting sent back to me. Pepe Silvia, Pepe Silvia. I look in the mail. Well, this whole box is Pepe Silvia. So I say to myself, I gotta find this guy. I gotta go up to his office. I gotta put his mail in the guy's goddamn hands. Otherwise, he's never gonna get it. He's gonna keep coming back down here. So I go up to Pepe's office, and what do I find out, Mac? What do I find out? There is no Pepe Silvia. The man does not exist, okay? So I decided, oh, shit, buddy, I gotta dig a little deeper. There's no Pepe Silvia, you gotta be kidding me. I got boxes full of Pepe. All right, so I start marching my way down to Carol in HR, and I knock on her door, and I say, Carol, Carol, I gotta talk to you about Pepe. And when I open the door, what do I find? There's not a single goddamn desk in that office. There is no Carol in HR. Mac. Half the employees in this building have been made up. This office is a goddamn ghost town.
Okay, Charlie, I'm gonna have to stop you right there. Not only do all of these people exist, but they have been asking for their mail on a daily basis. It's all they're talking about up there. Jesus Christ, dude, we are gonna lose our jobs.
Well, calm down, because here's one thing that's not gonna happen.
What?
We're not gonna get fired.
We're not.
Because we've already been fired.
We've lost our jobs?
Yeah. About 3 days ago, a couple pink slips came in the mail. One for you, one for me. So what did I do? I mailed them halfway to Siberia, okay?
If we've lost our jobs, that means we've lost our health insurance, which means all of this was for nothing. God damn it, dude, I'm having a panic attack.
Will you look at that? Sons of Liberty. Patriots meeting in our bar, speaking of revolution and freedom. Can you believe it, dear brother? We're witnessing history in the making.
I do not give a shit, Deandra. Now, get me a flagon of ale.
Get your own ale, Dick.
You are my slave. You have to get me flagons of ale. I saved you from being burned at the stake for being a witch.
You're the one who accused me of being a witch in the first place, Dennis.
Well, what's done is done. That's all in the past now. So you can either be a slave witch in the bar, or you can be a burned-up witch outside. Up to you. Flagon of ale now? Now, what do you folks think? It's a beautiful house, right?
Well, you know, I'm thinking this might be a bit large for what we need.
Oh, I'm sorry, buddy. Is this house too big for you?
Now, Vic.
Just a second, Hugh. Why don't you ask your wife what she needs, pal? Oh, I'm sorry. She used to something smaller. You don't think she can handle it?
Okay, I think we're gonna get going.
It's okay, you guys. I'm here. I want this to be a good experience for you, okay?
I'll tell you what, buddy. How about I take your wife upstairs and show her what it's like to be deep inside a really big house?
What?
Huh? What?
What? You'll have to excuse my associate. It's just his passion for quality real estate that makes him so intense. Now, what can we do to put you in this house?
Okay, look, I think we're just gonna go now.
Yeah. Are you gonna buy the house?
Okay,
we're gonna go.
Sir?
Are you going to
buy
this house?
We don't want any trouble, sir.
Are you going to buy this house?
Please?
Are you going to buy this house?
Yes!
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 What?
Yes!
That's it. There we go. That's all I wanted.
Yeah, congratulations, folks. You just bought a brand new house.
Can we go?
Yeah!
Go, gonna... go, honey. Go.
Congratulations.
Go.
I'm going.
Just
I'm
going. Go.
All right, we'll be in touch. That was amazing, bro. You think that's going to work? Bro, it already did work. You heard the skirt. She said, yes, I will buy this house. That is a binding verbal contract. Now, I heard it, you heard it, and that pussy husband of hers heard it, too.
Vinegar? Okay. Jesus Christ. All right, I'll get on it.
Well. If it isn't the big-time hotshot lawyer man.
Oh, my God. I do not have time for you.
Yeah, sir, we both have busy schedules, so I'll make this quick.
I shan't mince words with you for long. I am challenging you, sir, to a duel.
I accept.
Are you serious?
No, I accept your challenge.
Do you want time to think it over?
No. Nope, not at all. What time were you thinking of dueling?
Anytime is good, really. I don't know. You don't have time, because you would have to go out and get a proper gun.
No, I have a gun. I actually keep one right here in the drawer.
You got one right there? I don't need to see it.
I like to keep it loaded, because you never know who's going to walk into a law office these days.
Safety first. So, let's rethink some things. Let's say that you've learned your lesson now, and I've learned a little lesson. And we'll call it even, and I will respectfully decline the duel.
Well, you can't decline.
Eh?
As you know, once the duel's been accepted, you know, there's no backing out. I mean, that's the law.
Yep.
Anyway, great. This is settled, and I was looking for something to do tomorrow afternoon anyway. So I'm going to pencil you in for high noon tomorrow.
Don't do it.
And don't worry, because wherever you are, I'll find you.
Yeah.
I'm gonna put one right between your teeth, and it's just gonna pop out the back of your neck.
Deandra, can we talk to you for a sec?
Hey, you guys, watch me bust out this sweet jackknife.
Oh! Whoa! Italian market. These people are like descendants of gypsies. They come in, they sell their shit, they bang each other. I don't know what they do, but you get to haggle with them. It's a lot of fun. In the meantime, you know what? I'll prop this beer bottle under the door.
All right. That's good.
There we go.
Perfect.
Now, the weight of the door will keep the beer bottle in place.
Good.
Nice, huh?
Move over a little bit. Let me sit on the cooler.
God damn it!
All right, now this I can get in.
Measure the crack, and the crack is smaller than the height of the grill.
We're all hooked up here, dude.
Mm.
Now, are you nervous at all about leaving Philly? Like, is anything bad gonna happen?
I think so, man. I'm excited about it.
Well, you know, I've just never been outside of Philly. I don't know what people are like.
People are people.
Nobody's gonna be like a dick?
There's probably gonna be some dicks out there, yeah, sure. But I'll be there. I'll back you up, man.
Hey, thanks, man.
I'll tell you what'll help. A shotgun of beer?
That'll calm my nerves.
It sure will.
Let's head out.
Just easier than dealing with the pain. One way train. One way on a one-way track.
Right. I actually got this uncle out there that said that I'm
soon I'm over here, more there. Runaway train staring at the sidetrack.
Hey, D, I'm covered in piss!
Well, maybe you shouldn't have had your window down.
Maybe you shouldn't be throwing jars of pee out the window.
Maybe I shouldn't. It's up for debate.
You shouldn't!
Hey, what the hell is that?
Holy shit!
Get off me, dude!
Are we moving? I think we're stopped. Dee, what time is it?
7 a.m.
7 a.m.? Shit, we've been driving all night.
We're not moving, are we?
No. Whoa. Shit, do you think we're like halfway there? Or where do you
I wonder
we
how
are?
Far we got.
I wonder if we're like...
What the hell is this? Oh, be back at Patty's?
Wait, where the hell is my car? Oh, goddamn!
Shit,
what's going on?
I'm squeezed out. Well, let's see how far you two idiots get without Frank Reynolds bailing you out every 5 minutes. I'm out of here.
I'm comfortable being chaff if you want to be weak.
Okay, man, whatever.
You're firing us?
Well, first we're going to give you the opportunity to defend your jobs.
Really?
Yeah.
All right, I appreciate the opportunity, fellas.
All right.
I'm on it!
Okay. Show us what you do around here, Charlie. Woo, woo, woo.
This is bullshit. I shouldn't have to defend my job to you.
Dee, we don't know what it is that you do around here.
You don't really seem to do anything.
Me? Come on, I do a shitload.
Why don't you make us a drink?
Fine. I'll crack you open a beer.
No, not a beer. Something you have to mix.
But this bottle is cold activated.
I mean, look at it. Doesn't that look delicious?
It does look delicious, but mix me a drink.
But the mountains, they've turned blue. Don't
mojito you wanna... me, please.
A refreshing mojito would do.
Nobody orders a mojito in this bar.
So you can't make a mojito?
Of course I can make a mojito.
Then make one.
Fine. One mojito coming up, gentlemen. I quit.
God damn it! Shit! Almost done. Are we almost done?
No, we're not done. I got one more piece of business.
What is it?
Lastly, before I open the bar in the morning, I always make sure to turn on the Coors sign, let people know we got iced delicious Coors in the bar, you know, and then that's the last thing I do. Old Charlie's done a lot of work around here.
Charlie, that sign does not say Coors.
Eh?
Come outside. Come outside. Come outside.
God damn it.
Come outside.
Closed. It says closed, Charlie.
Okay. Yeah, right, I can see that now. But, you know, you can't really read it from the inside.
So... You can't read it from the outside.
All right, you know what? Forget it.
I can read it.
Are we done with this? Have we gone through everything?
Well, that was the last thing that I do. Sure.
Okay, great. You're fired.
All right. Well, that's the best you have? All right, now, pretend that this shoe is an unboned chicken, and you're going to cook it tonight, make a tasty dinner, and it's going to smell all through the house like cooked chicken.
Actually, I'm vegan.
Okay, then pretend this shoe is whatever you people eat. Maybe it is a shoe. Are you with somebody as resilient as Frank Reynolds?
You tried to off yourself two times in the last 24 hours, Frank.
Well, listen, this business partner of mine called. He's got a great plan. This is the man who's going to make us rich.
This is the man?
Yes.
This man lives in a cardboard box.
Times is tough.
God damn it.
Yo!
Hey! Thanks for getting down here so quick.
It's Charlie?
Charlie.
Charlie is your new business partner?
Yeah, well, what do you want? I mean, we're good in tight spots.
That's right. All right, you ready to do this?
You got it.
Okay, let's go.
You're the man with the plan.
Let's go.
Deandra, this is gonna work.
There we go.
Look at that. Ah. Feast your eyes.
Here we go.
What the hell is that?
These are crabs. Fresh local Delaware runoff crabs.
Those don't look anything like crabs. Huh? They look like sea scorpions. Well, isn't there some kind of like sewage runoff around here?
Yeah, there's a pretty bad sewage runoff.
Maybe we're not doing the right thing. You're talking a lot about wine. You got it all over your lips and teeth. And maybe we need the help of a professional. We should probably get that lady back.
What are you talking about? We're coming up with all kinds of good ideas. We're flowing here.
I feel like we got some good stuff.
I just feel like maybe we should consult with the pamphlets, right? The pamphlets I grabbed from the office.
Oh, okay. Well, I've been meaning to bring that up. I took a look at those pamphlets that you grabbed, and not a single one of them has anything to do with interventions. Not even close. As a matter of fact, I'm starting to think we need to intervene on you for your goddamn illiteracy.
Yeah, Charlie, you are getting real dumb.
Come on. All right. See, this is what I'm talking about, illiteracy. You know, what does that word even mean? Come on. I'm gonna get the lady, because this is getting crazy. We need help. I'm getting the lady.
Hey there, sleepyhead. I made you breakfast. I hope you like it crispy, because it is burned.
What is going on in here? How did you get in my house? Did you kick in my door?
Kick yes, kick in no. That door is solid, which is the good news. The bad news is the window is not. Now, that's going to be a security concern, but don't worry about it. I'm going to fix it, make sure it's up to snuff. You're always safe when you're with me.
All right, listen, you got to be on your toes tonight, okay? This chick's a lawyer. She's going to be pretty sharp, so stick to the game plan, okay?
She's a lawyer. I like that.
He's sweating through his shirt, dude.
I know. Listen, you remember your backstory? No?
You don't remember
your backstory? All right, listen, man, you're a philanthropist. That's what you are, okay? You used to own a small business, but you gave all that up to help others.
Right, now, who do I help? Who am I helping? God.
It doesn't matter. I don't know, old people, children, autistics, dyslexic folks.
It really
folks.
Doesn't matter.
I'm a full-on...
philanthropist.
Dude, I can't get it. Well, how do you say it? What is it?
Philanthropist! Meet us in the bathroom.
Oh, my God.
What is that? What was that? Is that cheese? Have you eaten cheese?
Hi.
Hi.
Are you Charlie Kelly?
Yeah, I am. Yeah.
Sorry, I'm late.
You're Jackie.
Yes, I am. Are you all right?
Yeah, this? I was running.
Okay, because you're bleeding.
Oh, shit. Is it bleeding again? I'm sorry. These are hornet stings, you know? I run into, like a lot of, like, hornets in my line of work, and I get stung up, like, bad all over my face and stuff, and then, you know, it starts bleeding.
Oh, sounds interesting.
Yeah.
What is it that you do again?
I'm like a janitor. And, I'm a full-on rapist, you know? Africans, dyslexics, children, that sort of thing.
I'm sorry. Did you say you're a full-on rapist?
No. No. I help people, you know what I mean? I'm a philanthropist? Yeah, that's exactly what it is. It gets blocked up in my mouth. I don't say it no good. So.
Hey, what's this?
This is for your engagement, man. You're lucky. Lucky dude, and congratulations to you.
No, that's not happening anymore. We're not engaged.
You're not getting married?
Nah.
Oh!
You're Charlie Kelly, right? Yeah, I remember you from high school.
Hang on a second, dude. You're not getting married?
Well, remember how everybody used to make fun of us in high school?
Remember how they made fun of you?
Anyway, I have been getting my revenge. I've been getting engaged to all these chicks who broke up with me in high school because of my acne, and then I dump them right before the wedding.
Damn.
Yeah, I just got through doing it to that coffee shop waitress. Now I'm gonna do it to this chick, Dee Reynolds. Remember her? She was the worst.
Yeah, so that coffee shop waitress, she must have been hurt kind of bad by that though, right?
Yeah. She was devastated.
Oh. So. Well, tell you what, man. Why don't you go ahead and have this present anyway?
Really?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like you deserve it.
Well, thanks, dude.
Yeah.
That's rad. All right, okay. Well, keep it real, man.
Okay.
All right.
Shitty, right?
Yeah.
Coffee car.
Yeah, no, you don't want to jump out in front of a shitty car.
We need rich people tickets, right?
I have rich seats, man. Right. Oh, ooh, this guy right here.
This is gonna be a good one, dude.
Oh, he's gonna have such good seats. Go. What are you doing, man? Bro, that guy was gonna have great seats.
Yeah, I felt like I didn't have a good angle.
What do you mean? Jump right out in front of
him. This guy will have good seats.
Don't get cold feet on me. Jump out in front of this guy.
This guy's good. And don't big look. I'm trying to have a conversation with the man behind the mask. I feel like you're big-legging me, dude. Are you taking me seriously?
Yeah. That guy's beating on the frenetic. Dude, is that a hate crime?
Nah, it's not a hate crime.
You want to hammer his ass anyway?
Definitely.
Guys, what are you doing? Who's Soldier of Fortune?
He's just this guy I've been chatting online with, whatever.
Oh, so that would make you Desert Rose?
Yes, it would.
Wow, what a couple of losers.
Oh, really? Okay, well, this loser that you're referring to happens to be an American soldier in Iraq.
Back it up. Don't joke about it.
I'm not joking.
Are you serious?
I'm dead serious, and his platoon's coming home this weekend, and we're gonna hang out together, so suck on that.
Yeah, I feel terrible.
Yeah. You should.
I feel terrible, too, because he's going to come back from Iraq and he's going to find out that he's been chatting with...
No. She looks ridiculous.
Desert Rose?
Yeah.
Hi.
What? Hi. What the hell?
Oh, it feels so good to finally hold you.
You're riding my lip.
Hi! Oh, what a coincidence.
Hey, you're the girl from the bus stop.
Yes, I am.
Well, you guys are friends, right?
Mm-hmm.
Not really.
Tell your friend thanks for the shorts. They fit great.
Yeah, will do. So, what's the deal with you standing? I thought there was a wheelchair and you were in it.
Oh, no. I twisted my knee getting off a plane in Germany. I was just trying to stay off of it.
It's about time, you know, we get some merchandise in here and I start making some money off this place.
What? What are you talking about? You're not going to make any money off this place. You don't own a piece of the bar.
No, but I own 100% of the merchandising. It's in my contract.
What contract?
The contract you had me sign when I first started working here.
Dee, we got you to sign that contract so we could pay you less than minimum wage, okay?
We have a past, mm-hmm. if you will. Mm-hmm. And Charlie and I really like the fact that you don't charge.
I do charge. Okay, you don't pay.
We're both men of the law, you know? We get after it, you know? We jabber jaw, we go tit for tat, we have our little differences. But at the end of the day, you win some, I win some, and there's a mutual respect left over between us.
Any respect that you're feeling that's coming from me is a mistake on your part.
Then I'll just regress, because I feel like I made myself perfectly redundant.
Yes, you have.
Do shots as they were intended by blasting them directly into your mouth.
awesome. I'm wasted.
But that's not all. Dicktow.com. Nudie pen.
Hey, does your cat walk around too much? Does your cat make too much noise? Guess who just found some investors for Kitten Mittens.
I told you, people love stupid shit.
Why do you keep calling it stupid,
it's
though?
It's really pretty stupid, but people stupid? Are stupid, too, so.
Hello.
Oh. Hey, there he is. Hey, what's up,
man? Nice. Hey.
What are you doing
very
here?
Good. Congratulations on the sale.
Thank you very much.
Oh, you were there.
Yeah. How much money am I gonna make?
Do what now?
Oh. The contract that you all blindly signed grants me 100% of the profits from any merchandising opportunities from your little bar. And Kitten Mittens, I own that.
Dude.
I had to get paid by you people somehow.
Well, that's what the hooker was for.
Dude. All right, touche. You out-lawyered me there, mm-hmm. Okay? Tell you what, though. Let's split Kitten Mittens 50-50, and then you'll never see me again.
Wow, 50-50. Let me think about that. How about if I never see you again because the contract that you all signed also included a restraining order, which you're all currently violating?
Excuse me, sir, can I see these supposed documents that you have?
Why, yes. In fact, I happen to have that right here.
It's still new enough to be edible. That's an edible contract.
Right in your face.
Really? Yeah, you know, fortunately, I made hundreds of copies of that. So why don't y'all have just a nice day?
You can probably stop eating that now.
Okay, just stop right there. Okay. And off with the... Okay, here we are! I set up a picnic for us!
What the hell are you doing?
What? I set up a picnic. Do you not like picnics?
Okay, all right, I know what's going on. I'm on to you, guy. You bring me out here to some landfill in the middle of nowhere. You blindfold me so I have no idea where I am. I'm gonna depend on you to get home.
Do you want to go?
Yeah, oh yeah, I want to go, but not with you. I'll go all by myself. I'll take the bus, and I'll also take this, thank you.
Well, here, do you want a glass?
No, stop it.
What, do you need bus fare?
I don't need bus fare.
I'm not sure the bus comes out here anyway.
Okay, I'll walk then, okay?
What, in your heels? They're very nice. What, here, take my boots.
Stop it! Stop trying to make me depend on you, okay? I'm fine all by myself, buddy. I'm doing just fine by myself.
Oh my God!
What if he can smell crime?
What if he smells crime?
Dude. What if he can smell a crime before it even happens?
Holy shit, dude, that's amazing. Smells crime before it even happens. Yes, dude.
What if his entire head is just one big nose?
All right, you guys got 30 seconds. Blow my mind.
Okay. All right, okay. Guys. It's the prequel to The Sixth Sense. The fifth sense, the sense of smell.
Check out this one over here. Does he look Indian to you?
Yes, dude.
It would be great to have an Indian in our corner, right?
Oh my God, they're natural storytellers. They're great with twists. Where are you from?
Baltimore.
Right,
Baltimore,
right.
Sure,
where are your parents from?
Jersey.
My gut feeling is they went a little overboard. I mean, can you even tell that it's me?
Yeah, it's perfect. We need to pair you up with the husband for the shot.
Husband?
Yeah.
How about this guy right here?
That'll work.
Great.
Holy shit, dude, D.
This is like...
Wow, I could barely tell that was you.
I mean, what, did they dip you by your heels
That's
into the blood?
That's ridiculous.
What the hell is
that?
That
looks so stupid. Frank had him go a little more subtle with me so you could see my face. I'd be
this?
Featured.
Yeah. This is it?
Yeah.
How the hell did you manage that?
No, I'm working my ass
Come
off.
Come on, Seth, let's go now.
Come on.
Why are you saying brains? What?
Oh, because it's a zombie movie. It's like the Shyamalan twist. I figured it out.
This is not a zombie movie. It's a movie about Serbian genocide.
Really?
Oh, shit, do we need him to execute our script?
Yeah.
Actually, you guys don't need Shyamalan to execute your script because I've got the mother of all Shyamalan twists in my hand right here. You see, you think I've just been playing with my phone the whole time, but you're wrong. I've been writing a little movie script of my own, and I finished it right before you guys called.
It's a horror movie about two men trapped in a garage stairwell who get hunted down by a psychotic homeless killer who turns out to be a security guard instead.
That's our story, dude.
Damn right it's your story, and that's why you two guys are gonna be attached as producers.
Nice! Producers! Baby. Oh,
all right. I feel like that's what I'm
love showbiz, dude. I love showbiz.
Can I be in it?
You know, normally, Dee, I would take this opportunity to insult you, but I'm gonna throw an insane twist your way. You're gonna be the lead of the film.
I am, really?
No, you're not. Twist it again. Boom, try and keep up. Lot of twists. Lot of twists in this thing. So try and keep up.
There's so many twists, I can't even follow.
It's tough to follow.
I'm gonna pull up the first scene right now so you guys can get a little taste of what else is going on in this film.
It's
really good.
Lay us on it.
For some reason, the phone is frozen, and I'm having a little trouble pulling up the scene. It's frozen. And why is there grease all over? Is this Frank's goddamn sausage grease? Frank, you froze my phone with your sausage greasy fingers! Frank, you son of a bitch!
Why don't you focus some of that weird rage on him?
Yeah,
Charlie and I will handle the frat kids from here, okay?
Yeah, yeah. I'll totally pull a Goodwill Hunting on those kids, and that'll put them in their place.
How are you gonna do that?
Well, you've seen the movie, right?
Yeah.
So all I gotta do is I'll ask them some, like, big shot, like, math or science history-type college question, and then I'll totally stump them by knowing a lot more about the answer than they do.
Yeah, in that movie, Matt Damon played a genius janitor. You're just a janitor.
What do you guys want?
We want one game of Flip Cup. If you guys win, you get to drink at our bar forever, for free.
If we win, we get to come to your frat whenever we want.
And paint girls.
And get painted by them.
And take showers with them.
Lots of showers.
Okay, you're on.
All right, these guys are gonna be really fast. So we need to get out into a quick lead. So Dee, I want you to start us off.
Really?
Yes. Charlie, you're gonna take us home as the anchor.
Naturally.
Oh, all right. Guys. You guys, I am not gonna let you down, okay?
I know you're not, sis. I'm proud of you.
We're really proud of you. All right, Frank, you wanna start us off with some kind of cheer or something?
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Patties! 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 Yeah! Woo!
All right. Woo! All right. Okay, both teams ready?
Yeah.
Go!
Go, team! Go, team!
Go,
go, team!
Go! Go, team! Go!
Go! Go! Go! Go! Go! Go!
Come on,
Dave! Come on, Dave! Don't go so hard! Don't go hard!
Challenge him to one more, you know what I mean? I feel like we could really get these guys.
Don't you see, Dee? We've already won.
What does that mean? What are you talking about? Oh, God.
Ew. Hey, what? Whoa, what's going on with me?
Oh, William, what's going on is that you just drank a cup of poison.
I thought you guys believed in me. You were so proud of me.
We knew you were gonna choke.